Good morning, New Life. Good morning, family. It's good to see everyone and just glad to be together worshiping God. If you have your family members with you, would you just gather them around as we are about to just open up in prayer and begin to worship, begin to let our songs and our hearts, our spirits give glory to the God Most High. I just believe right now in this season that there's some things that God is doing with the church. Right now, there's really a call upon us as the people of God to begin to move in power, to begin to move as a body, as the ecclesia of God, and that we are going to be people who have the ability to make a difference in our society. And so I just feel the Lord is calling us as a church to rise up, to awaken, to be alive in this season, to not be hidden, to not be afraid, to not be in a state of comatose or asleep, but really be awakened in Him. And so we just release that right now over every person, everybody that's attending, that's tuning in right now and about to worship our God. Let us give Him our highest praise. As the government and the city and there's the things that are saying that we can't worship, but God, we're going to say, regardless of what people are saying, we're going to continue to worship because that is the source of your power, and that is the source of heaven. So we speak over that right now. Would you join me? Let's pray together. Father God, we just ask your kingdom to come and invade our homes, invade our hearts, invade our lives, and let us be the light of this world. For you have called us to be the church that is meant to be the hope for this world, the hope for the lost. And so, Father God, I ask you, come and just meet us in this time. And as we worship you, would you begin to bring more of your glory, more of your revelation into our lives that heaven would invade. And we just release our hearts to you as we praise you. And God, we say, and would you say this with me? Just say, God, awaken us. Awaken me. God, would you awaken us? Awaken us right now. Awaken me in this season. Awaken your sons and daughters. Awaken your church. Awaken, O Lord. Awaken, awaken. In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray. And we all say, amen.
worship you.
Now my life is
Consume my life. Let you.
Jesus, your love is like a fire. Your love is like a fire that burns for all to see. My only desire to worship at your feet. So let this fire consume my life. Let your love take me deeper. Oh, draw me closer to
只有在你的同在里面，主，我们得到安息。住在你的同在里，我们里面 ，Lord, we have everything we need, everything we want. Thank you, Jesus, for that promise of your presence, Lord. Thank you for your Holy Spirit, come like fire.Hallelujah, 像火一样的炼净我们，洁净我们，叫我们跟父跟你一样的圣洁。Help us to go deeper and deeper, and let us experience that holiness in your presence, Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus.
Hey, 弟兄姐妹平安。
Hey, brothers and sisters, peace to you.
感谢主给我们一个非常棒的敬拜。
Thank God that we have a wonderful time of worship.
让我们能够经历神的确是与我们同在。
Let us encounter a God who is, his presence is always with us.
今天我们很高兴能够邀请到 Pastor Daniel 在我们的当中。
Really excited this morning that we can invite Pastor Daniel to be in our midst.
我相信很多的弟兄姐妹都认识他。
I trust that many of our brothers and sisters, you all know him well.
他们的家还有他们的家人也都在我们的教会服侍有十几年的时间。
Pastor Daniel and his family and family members have been in our church and served in our church for many years now.
那多年前，神给 Pastor Daniel 一个负担新建立的一个。Mission organization. Yeah.
A couple of years ago, Pastor Daniel felt a calling to start a missional organization.
称之叫做桥梁事工 Nlcc Ministry.
And this ministry is called Nlcc Ministry.
是帮助那些在回教中的国家，还有帮助那些在被逼迫的国家当中的教会。
It's this ministry that really goes out to the countries that are under a lot of oppression, that may be in poverty, and to do ministry and minister to them.
在父亲节的前几天，有一次我跟 Pastor Daniel， 我们有机会，我跟他坐下来一起喝茶。
I remember one time just before Easter came by, Pastor Daniel and I went to go have some coffee together.
那么我们两个人在谈话的当中
，and as we were discussing。
他就跟我分享了神在宣教工厂的工作。
God, he started to share about the things that God was doing out in the mission field.
然后他就提到神感动他有一个 project， 就是为耶稣停下来一分钟祷告。
And he shared with me how God had put on his heart a project which he would stop every now and then for a minute to pray to Jesus.
我不知道为什么，当我们两个人在谈话的时候，忽然间圣灵很深的感动我。停止我们的 conversation， 我们的对话。
And as we were talking about this, all of a sudden I felt a very strong move of the Holy Spirit telling me to stop and to not talk anymore, but actually pray.
所以 Pastor Daniel 也吓了一跳，他说：“牧师怎么了？”我说 ：“We need to pray right now. 我们现在需要祷告。”
And Pastor Daniel was a little bit taken back and shocked for a moment, and he asked Pastor Andrew, "What's going on?" And I said to him, "I feel we need to pray right now."
所以我们两个人就花了一段时间一起来为。
So the two of us spent some time to pray for this project.
我就想到在圣经里面有一个瞎眼的巴底买。
I remember in the Bible there is a blind man named Bartimaeus.
当耶稣经过的时候
，and when Jesus was passing by,
非常多的人
，many people were following him.
但是呢，巴底买用很大的声音说。大卫的子孙，可怜我吧！他在那里呼求耶稣的帮助。
But Bartimaeus was crying out to the Lord and saying, "God, Lord, Lord, come, help me."
那么耶稣就为了他的缘故停下脚步。
And Jesus, because of his cry, he stopped in his tracks.
耶稣停下来的几分钟当中，完全改变了巴底买的人生。
In just a couple of minutes that Jesus stopped for Bartimaeus, it changed his entire life.
他的瞎眼被医治了。
He was no longer blind.
所以我们可以看到，我们可以为耶稣停下来一分钟，来为这些困苦当中的人祷告。
And so through this, we see that if we could just take 1 minute to stop and pray to Jesus.That there are things he can do to change.
弟兄姐妹，你相信祷告能够改变一切的情况吗？
Do you believe, brothers and sisters, that prayer can change all kinds of circumstances?
我邀请每一个弟兄姐妹，我们参与，给耶稣一分钟，为耶稣停下来祷告。
So I want to invite all brothers and sisters, if you're willing, if you could give Jesus just 1 minute of your time.
好，这个时候让我们热烈欢迎 Pastor Daniel 在我们当中。
Brother and sister in New Life, a greeting from New Life Church.
弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
I'm so excited, and it has been for a long time, and I cannot see everyone. At least, and someone you can see me. I'm Daniel Wu.
非常高兴，我终于可以在这里跟大家见面。虽然我不能够看到你们，但是你们可以看到我。
And probably most of people know my wife Sharon than me, and because I'm too lazy sometimes.
大家可能比较认识我的太太 Sharon 师母，我是 Pastor Daniel.
And I would like to share with you a very romantic sermon.
今天要跟大家分享一个非常浪漫的信息。
Kiss it goodbye.
吻别。
And probably in my generation, we have a song very popular.
在我那个年代，有一首非常流行的歌。
Kiss me goodbye.
就叫做吻别。
And I hope you remember, like we choose it, win or lose it, love is never quite the same. And It's a wonderful song, which I heard oh, many, many times when I was young.
这是非常浪漫的一首歌，叫《吻别》。我年轻的时候常常听。
And in the Old Testament, there were women called Naomi.
在旧约里头有一个女子叫做拿俄米。
And because of famine, and she and her husband and with children, they moved out from Bethlehem to Moab.
因为饥荒的缘故，她的跟她的丈夫跟两个孩子就一起离开了伯利恒，他们到了摩押底。
And the life was not bad.
生活还不错。
And plenty of food.
也有很多的食物。
But all of a sudden, she never dreamed, and her husband died.
但是突然的，她丈夫过世了。
And another 10 years later, two of his sons died.
十年以后呢，她的两个儿子也陆续死亡。
And she was full of disappointment.
所以她非常的沮丧。
So she decided to move back to Bethlehem.
所以她决定要回去伯特利。
And then she told her two daughter-in-law, go home and start a new life.
所以她就告诉她的两个儿媳妇说，你们可以回去了。
And Pastor Catherine can help me to read Luke chapter 1 and 1 to 5.
我就来跟大家读路德记一章一到五节。当士师秉政的时候，国中遭遇饥荒，在犹大伯利恒有一个人带着妻子跟两个儿子往摩押地去寄居，这人名叫以利米勒，他的妻名叫拿厄米，他两个儿子，一个名叫马伦，一个名叫基连，都是犹大的伯利恒的以法他人。他们到了摩押地就住在那里。后来拿厄米的丈夫以利米勒死了，剩下妇人和他两个儿子。这两个儿子娶了摩押女子为妻，一个名叫厄尔巴，一个名叫路德，在那里住了约有十年。马伦和基连两人也死了，剩下拿厄米没有丈夫，也没有儿子。
It was not a very good beginning of the story.
这个故事开始并不怎么好。
And what a sad story as a woman have this experience.
其实对一个女人来讲，这是一个很伤心的故事。
And then at this point, at verse 14, and this is how she talked to her two daughter-in-law.
在路德记一章十四节这样子说，他怎么样跟他的媳妇说
？They weep loud again.
两个媳妇就放声大哭。
Now after that, they decided kiss one of her daughter-in-law and say goodbye.
厄尔巴就跟她的婆婆亲嘴告别，只是路德舍不得。
Hey, can you never imagine about Naomi, this mother-in-law, this?Old lady.
你可以想象拿俄米这一位婆婆老妇人。
I think she should be somewhere like a little bit younger than me, maybe 40, 50 years old.
她可能也是四五十岁了，没那么老。
Because she already have two sons and married two daughter-in-law.
因为她已经有两个儿子跟两个儿媳妇。
And as a mother-in-law, and she loved the Lord, I believe she served the family.
但是他是一个很敬畏神的人，他也服侍他的家人。
And, hey, I did so much for you, daughter-in-law.
他可能会想说，媳妇啊，我为你做了这么多的事情。
What a life I have now.
你看我现在的日子是怎么样
？And you can remarry.
那你可以再嫁。
You can find a job.
你可以再找丈夫。
You have more opportunity I never have.
你有更多的机会，但是我没有。
And I'm an old woman, and now, are you betraying me?
但是我现在是一个老妇人，那你要离开我吗？
And even though I said you go home, but have you never have a little bit thought about me?
虽然我说哎呀你回去，但是你有没有想到我呀？
And then, you know, the point is, you know, God sometimes closed door.
所以重点是有的时候神关了一扇门。
And like,Naomi,
就像拿俄米一样
God closed all the doors for her.
好像神已经把所有的门关闭
She went to a point of end.
但是她好像到了一个终点
And she can be very angry.
她也可以非常的生气
Why you want to leave me?
为什么你要离开我
And why you say, can you say something good to me?
为什么你不说一些好听的话给我
But she didn't.
但是她没有
She did not complain.
她也没有抱怨。
And she did not bring her anger and so to her daughter-in-law.
她也没有把她心中的怒气发在她的媳妇身上。
I think in our life,
我想在我们的生命中
there's so many opportunity.
也有很多的机会。
And through man and woman, or your boss, or your parent, and so on, they brought it to us.
我们身边有很多的家人、工作或者是亲人在我们身边。
And maybe someone, you know, God ordained them to be your blessing.
也许神是透过他们来祝福你。
Well, there's some season is really wonderful.
有些这样的祝福的季节是很棒的。
Have you never thought that season can go to the end?
但是你知道，有的时候这个季节也会有结束的时候。
So the key is how we handle when we go to the door which God closed.
所以当我们面对上帝关了门的时候，我们怎么样子来面对？
We can be very angry.
我们可以很生气。
Naomi can give a slap to her daughter-in-law and walk away.
拿米也可以赏他媳妇一个耳光就走开了。
And but Naomi choose to give her a kiss.
但是拿米选择跟他吻别。
And I think, you know, you and I experience something in life.
我想我们在生命中都多少有这样的经历。
We are so disappointed.
我们非常的失望。
And why that happened?
为什么会发生这个事情呢？
I invest so many in your life.
我经历了这么多的事情。
And I train you.
我训练了你。
I teach you.
我教你。
I support you. I finance you.
我用财务上的支持你。
And now I have need.And you walk away.
现在我有需要的时候，你却走开了。
And you get angry.
你会觉得很生气。
Or you can like Naomi.
你也可以像拿俄米。
Weep and say goodbye.
你可能哭泣，但是你说再见。
And so that daughter-in-law represent a broken dream.
这个媳妇呢，好像代表一个已经破碎的梦。
And a lot of hurt.
有很多的
受伤, a lot of disappointment,
很多失望,
and things she didn't understand.
有很多她不能了解的事情。
Why I marry a husband and all the family broken apart?
为什么我结婚了，然后我的家庭完全破碎了。
Husband gone, and now I have no food. I become nothing.
我的丈夫走了，然后我也没有食物，我什么都没有。
And Naomi probably represents a woman who after God.
Naomi 是一个敬畏神的人。
And represents he determined to reach to the Father's destiny.
她是一个刻意要遵守神命定的人。
And she wants to kiss the bitterness goodbye.
她要对这些苦毒的事情吻别。
And she wants to kiss those person who left her goodbye.
他要跟那些离开他的人吻别。
Dream didn't work out. Goodbye.
跟那些没有实现的梦吻别。
Because I know God is still in control.
因为我知道神还是在掌权。
And He is still my God. He watch over me.
他还是我的神，他会看顾我。
But I have to learn how to say goodbye for the past.
但是我必须学习如何跟过去说再见。
And Ruth.Chapter 4, 15 and 17.
好，路德记四章十五到十七节，他必让你的生命重新得力，奉养你，使你安度晚年，因为他是爱你的儿媳妇所生的，有这儿媳妇比有七个儿子还要好。
16 and 17.
拿俄米接过婴孩抱在怀中照顾他，邻居的妇女们喊着说，拿俄米有孩子了，他们给孩子取名叫俄贝德，这俄贝德就是耶西的父亲，耶西是大卫的父亲。
Wow, what a wonderful, you know, ending of this story.
这故事的结束非常的好。
And, you know, Ruth, one of her daughter-in-law, marry a wealthy man.
她的一个媳妇路德，结果嫁给了一个非常有钱的人。
And have a baby.
他们生了一个孩子。
And I think,Naomi at that point, when she was holding this baby, she never thought, I can be that happy. And this is to fulfill all my disappointment.
当拿俄米抱着这个 baby 的时候，她真的觉得哇，好像她的梦想再次成真，她所有的失望都消失了。
Brother and sister, I think you and I, we have something, you know, very difficult to let go.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，我知道我们有些事情我们是很难让她走的。
And maybe you don't have peace for the past.
也许你对过去你并没有平安。
And maybe someone even still carry their bitterness.
也许对某些人你还是心中有苦毒。
You feel you lost something you shouldn't lose.
你可能失去了有些你觉得你不应该失去的。
And maybe you thought, you know, this plan, it should work. Why didn't it work because of this and that?
你觉得我这个计划应该要成就的，为什么没有呢？是因为什么？
You know, many people like to repeat, to think about the past.
很多人我们都会想不断地在过去里头重复。
And we live for the pain of the past.
我们在过去的伤痛中生活。
We don't want to bring this self-pity to a new day.
我们不要把这种自哀自怜带到一个新的生命里。
And nobody knows what happened tomorrow or even next month, America or this world.
没有人知道明天到底会怎么样。
Maybe, you know, you will even experience worse in the coming month.
也许会比现在更糟糕。
But you have to carry on and to believe just like Naomi and it will be passed.
但是你必须像拿俄米一样继续向前，知道这一切不好的都会过去。
Because God prepared a much better place for you.
因为神会为你预备一个更好的地方。
And just like, you know, He prepared plenty of food, a warehouse of all the abundant for you.
就好像他提供了很多的食物，非常的丰富，就是为了你。
But you have to let go the past.
但是你必须让过去的过去。
And otherwise, the new thing will not coming in.
不然的话，新的东西进不来。
So I have to learn how to kiss the past and then let me release me into a better future.
所以我必须学习跟过去说再见，然后向新的一个生活来拥抱。
And in the Bible, there's another prophet has similar experience.
教会里头有一位先知，他有类似的故事。
And prophet Samuel, and God called him to ordain Saul as a king of Israel.
就是先知撒母耳，上帝拣选他来高扫罗做以色列的王。
And well, it's very clear. This is what God told this prophet.
非常清楚，这就是神要他做的事情。
He did not listen wrong.
他没有听错。
And it's God's plan for Saul as a king of Israel.
是神拣选扫罗做以色列的王。
And Samuel was listening to God.
Samuel 很听神的话。
And he went to him and trained him when he was young.
他从小就训练他，就教导他。
And because he wanted to prepare him become the next king of Israel.
因为他要训练扫罗成为一个以色列的王。
And it takes time. It will not happen just overnight.
那这要花时间，他并不一夜就会成就。
And so slowly he grew up.
所以扫罗慢慢地成长了。
And the Bible gave him many good words about Saul.
所以扫罗也曾经很好，做了很多好事。
And the Bible said he was tall, he was handsome.
因为他长得又高大又俊美。
And people like him.
百姓很喜欢他。
And as his mentor or his pastor, and what Samuel thought of this?
作为他的一个导师，撒母耳一定是非常的开心。
He must be so proud. I have a wonderful disciples.
他一定对我有这样子的一个孩子觉得非常的骄傲。
And but time went by.
但时间过去了。
And so lost his kingship.
扫罗他失去了他的这个国王的位分。
And Samuel was very disappointed.
Samuel 非常的失望。
What have I invest my life in this young man?
我花了这么多时间在这个年轻人身上。
It seems what a waste.
只是变得好像好浪费。
Have you never had this kind of experience?
你有这样的经验吗？
And you've been invest your life and helping a certain brother and sister and your family, and I think I don't have to carry on.
你花了很多很多的时间、力气、财务在支持或者帮助你的家人或者是朋友，但是你到一个点，你就觉得说，哦，不知道该怎么办。
I think you know you can fully I can ident this scripture identify with Pastor Chan.
可能陈牧师会有这样的感觉。
And, or maybe many elders.
也许教会的很多理事。
Many pastors in this church.
牧师们。
And you did all your best to serve the congregation.
你觉得说我已经尽我所有的力量来服侍这个教会。
We are not perfect, but at least we do our best.
我们都不完美，但是最起码我们都努力了。
But why people come, people go?
那为什么人来又人走呢？
And what a waste! Am I wasting my time in this church?
我是不是在这里浪费我的时间呢？
Hey, I want to encourage new life leadership.
我要鼓励新生命的领导者。
You're not alone.
你不孤单。
Yes, there are so many people like you.
Yes, 我们很多人都有同样的一个感觉。
You did all your best, and you're not perfect.
我们都做我们所能够做的，但我们都不完美。
And but how come? What a waste! And I doing something wrong?
但是我们觉得说，我好像在浪费我的时间，我是不是做错事情了？
But when you think about that, you have to read Samuel chapter 16, verse 1.
但是你做这个有这样的感觉的时候，你要读撒母耳记上十六章。
Samuel have the same feeling, maybe as you and I, that we feel so sad.
因为撒母耳有这样子感觉，也许你我都有。
And even maybe Samuel already depressed.
可能撒母耳都已经有忧郁了。
So God spoke to him.
所以神对他说
Can you read?
撒母耳记上十六章一节耶和华对撒母耳说我既厌弃扫罗做以色列的王你为他悲伤要到几时呢你将膏油盛满了脚我差遣你往伯利恒人耶西那里去因为我在他众子之内预定了一个做王的
You know when I read this scripture I have a picture
当我读在这个经文的时候我有一个图画
I felt God lose His patience to Samuel.
我觉得神好像对撒母耳已经失去了他的耐心。
I think you know he was a prophet.
他是一个先知啊。
God must be reveal him.
神一定会对他有启示。
God must spoke to him number of times.
神一定对他讲了很多次。
But he still lying on the bed.
但是他还是躺在床上。
So this time, the Lord came to him.
所以这次神就到他这里来。
I feel God kicking his butt.
我觉得神好像踢他一脚。
What are you doing here?
你为什么这样子呢？
Don't you understand?
你难道不明白我吗？
And you are the mature prophet.
你是一个很成熟的先知。
You are the priest.
你是一个祭司。
You are the leader of Israelites.
你是以色列的领导者。
And why are you depressed?
你为什么躺在这里这么样子的沮丧呢？
So it spoke to me.
所以他对我讲话。
Sometimes I depress.
有时候我也觉得很失望。
And I lie on the bed.
我也躺在床上。
So I really felt God. Sometimes He lose His patience to me.
我觉得有时候神也对我失去了耐心。
Like He pick me up and kick my back.
好像他把我拉起来，把踢我一脚。
And then you know, I think this is our life. We will go up and down.
这好像我们的生活，我们有的时候起起伏伏。
And finally, Samuel went to Jesse's house and find David.
所以，最终撒母耳到了耶西的家，找到了大卫。
You cannot compare the external condition to David and Saul.
你没有办法比较这个外表的情况。
David was a shepherd.
大卫只是一个牧羊的孩子
And the youngest in the family
他是最小的
Nobody looked him up
没有人看中他
And even after Samuel was ordained him He still continued as a shepherd shepherd, yeah.
yeah 即使是在撒母耳膏他了以后他还是继续做一个牧羊人
He did not So I am a future king of Israel
他并没有说、oh, 我是以色列 的王
And butThe Bible said he's a man after God's heart.
但是圣经说大卫是一个合神心意的人。
Brother and sister, don't wandering in your self-pity.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹们，我们不要在自哀自怜当中继续的流连忘返。
And if you do that, your eye will bright.
如果你这样子的话，你的眼睛会被蒙蔽。
And I believe this is a payback time.
我相信这是我们要回转的时候了。
It's a payday. And it's God will going to reward us.
神要来祝福我们。
And God saw you. God watch over you. You have many unfair in your life.
神 看到你生命中有很多你觉得不公平的事情。
In injustices.
很不公义。
And you have a lot of womb.
可能你成长中有很多的创伤。
And maybe you couldn't understand why it repeatedly happened to you.
可能你不了解为什么这个不断重复的发生。
But believe in God.
但是相信神。
And I believe it's a payday.
我相信有一天这些都是会回转的。
And God going to reward you.
神要祝福你。
And one dream, one of your dream, maybe die.
可能有一个梦已经死去了。
But it will not stop God's plan.
但是上帝的计划却不会停止。
Do you believe God can give you another dream?
你相信上帝会给你另外一个梦想吗？
I believe.
我相信。
I don't want to give up this dream.
我不想放弃我的梦想。
Maybe, you know, I did something wrong. This dream was wrong. Go to the end.
也许我做错梦了，这个梦想不适合我，然后就没有成就。
But that's okay. I'm a human.
没有关系，因为我只是人。
Well, I make mistake.
我们都会犯错。
I think that I at least I will come before God say sorry.I make mistake.
但是我们就可以到神面前来说，哦，对不起，上帝，我做错了。
Maybe I heard something wrong and I misunderstood God.
也许我听错了，我没有正确的了解神的心意。
But God will not give me up.
但是神不会放弃我们。
He will not give me up because I listen wrong. I go into wrong direction.
神不会放弃我们，即使我们是听错了或者我们走错路。
Well, let's finish this. Kiss it goodbye with.Book of Philippians chapter 3, 12 and 13.
让我们对这段吻别，我们用腓立比书三章十二十三节来结束。这不是说我已经得着了，已经完全了。我乃是竭力追求，或者可以得着基督耶稣，所以得着我的。弟兄们，我不是以为自己已经得着了，我只有一件事，就是忘记背后，努力面前的，向着标杆直跑，要得神在基督耶稣里从上面召我来得的奖赏。
I believe God going to reward us.
我相信神会祝福我们的。
And this is His promise.
这是他的应许。
But how can we get this reward?
但是我们怎么样子来得到这样子的一个祝福呢？
I truly believe.A team word or a team spirit.
我非常相信一个团队，一个团队的精神。
We only have one person to get this reward.
我们只有一个人得到这样的奖赏。
It's not you or me.
不是你或我。
It is Jesus.
是耶稣。
And if we follow Jesus to run this race, and we will get this reward together with Jesus.
如果我们跟着耶稣，我们一起来跑，奔跑这个天路，我们会跟着耶稣也一起得到这个奖赏。
So, brother and sister, you have no choice. You have to love me.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我们就是要彼此相爱。
We need each other.
因为我们彼此都有需要。
Because if you get the reward, I will jealous you.
因为你如果拿奖赏，我会觉得嫉妒。
If I get this reward, you will jealous me.
如果我拿了奖赏，你也会嫉妒。
As a result, nobody will get this reward.
所以这样子的话，没有人能够得到奖赏。
But if Jesus have this reward,
但是如果主耶稣得到了这个奖赏。
And I think we're all happy.
那我们都很开心。
So we have to follow Jesus. We have to love one another.
所以我们都要跟随耶稣，要彼此相爱。
And we have to have a teamwork.
我们要有团队的精神。
In order to please our Lord Jesus Christ.
来讨神的喜悦。
So I would like to share with you something about Nlcc.
我来跟大家分享一下我们桥梁事工。
And last couple of months, to be honest, I'm quite busy.
最近几个月其实我非常的忙。
And I came to America in 1996.
我1996年来到美国。
I think until now, this is the longest day or months I stay in America.
在这段疫情期间，大概是我待在美国最长的时候。
And praise the Lord. And again, you know, maybe you can say one dream die, but if you keep dreaming, God have give us another dream.
感谢神，你可以说有一个梦想可能已经结束，但是神会继续不断的给我们其他的梦想。
And we are not stuck by the virus.
我们并没有因为这个病毒而停止。
And God opened many doors for us.
神其实开了很多的门。
And I will invite you to participate in our campaign called Give Jesus 1 Minute.
我要邀请大家跟我们一起参与给耶稣一分钟这样子的一个活动。
Our Heavenly Father can do what we cannot.
我们的天父可以做我们做不到的事情。
He can help more victims of disaster and save more souls.
他可以帮助我们帮助更多的灾民拯救更多的灵魂。
And from mid of March and until today,
从三月中一直到现在
we distribute over 40,000 masks.
我们捐了四万个口罩。
Now, and then other supplies and totally, you know, a little bit over 60,000 US dollar.
还有很多其他的防疫用品，总共大概有六万美金到很多需要的地方。
And then we bless the Lebanese, Syrian refugees and northern war zone refugees. We call them IDP within Syria, Kurds, Armenian.And Pakistanis, Bangladesh, Laos, and Burma refugees.
在这段时间，我们帮助了很多黎巴嫩的人、叙利亚难民、北部战区的难民、叙利亚国内流离失所的人、库尔德人、亚美尼亚人、巴基斯坦、孟加拉、辽国跟缅甸的难民。
And I remember Pastor Chan had been preaching a sermon really touched me.
陈牧师有一个信息非常的感动我。
And I think it was in March or April. It says sowing during famine.
在三月或四月，他讲了一个信息，就是说在饥荒的时候我们撒种。
And we can experience hundredfold of harvest.
我们可以经历到百倍的收成。
And we experience that, brother and sister.
这就是我们经历到的。
And it seems like that's impossible in this time for finance.
好像在这段时间财务上是非常困难。
We never experienced that abundantly and people how they support us from different places.
我们无法想象到会有这么多人在不同的方面来支持我们。
But you know, March, we're starting to cut our budget 30% for all field support and salary and operation.
但其实在三月的时候我们开始大概删减了 30% 的所谓薪资或者是费用开销等等。
And then mid-March, and the field from Lebanon asked us, can you send us some masks?
三月中的时候，黎巴嫩的那个区传来消息说，我们可不可以送一些口罩去？
I said, are you kidding me?
我说你开玩笑吧。
We just cut budget.
我们才刚刚削减经费。
You ask for something more?
你还要更多。
But we experience.
但是
it seems like it's just a wrong time.
但是很奇妙的，似乎是在不对的时候。
And you're in the wrong place.
你好像在不对的地方。
And don't do the wrong thing.
好像在不对的做不对的事情。
And this is our humans, knowledge.
这就是我们靠着人，我们这样子想。
And we want to do the right thing with logic.
但是我们常常在逻辑里面，我们要做对的事情。
But God said to Isaac, "Don't go to Egypt."
但是神告诉这个。
以撒
不要去埃及
and stay in the famine place and to farm
在这个饥荒的地方去撒种
you know some people I heard in Pakistan they have to eat the seed because they have no food
你知道在巴基斯坦我知道有些人他们必须吃种子因为他们没有食物
that's disaster
这就是灾难
the seed for you to have food and you eat that means that's the only thing they have.
种子是可以让你带来食物的，但是他们却连种子都要吃，因为没有食物。
Let's see, you know, in Pakistan.
在巴基斯坦。
And now, actually, from March until now, we have to stop everything in Pakistan and this week.
在三月到现在，我们其实很多事情都需要停止。
And we have been do relief.And you can see the picture, and we have rice, and we also have coupon for poor people that we can provide something for them.
我们试着送一些米或者是一些食物券或一些粮食给他们。
And actually, in January or beginning of February, I was in Pakistan.
事实上在二月中我是在巴基斯坦。
And that time we still can do something.
那时候我们还可以做点事。
So it remind me again, you know, time is not waiting for us.
所以也提醒了我的我们时间并不等我们。
So I thank God in March, April, and even in May, we continue to do relief in Pakistan.
所以感谢神，从三月到五月，我们继续做这些支援救援的工作。
And if you see the video, you will see, you know, we never have this opportunity.Because quarantine, the pastor in the roof and begin to leading praise and worship and communion.
如果等一下大家看短片，你会看到在巴基斯坦，我竟然可以有牧师在阳台上来一起跟大家敬拜、赞美、祷告。
And then we Bangladesh as well. We have to stop basically almost everything.
在孟加拉也一样，我们很多事情没有办法做。
But from March.April and May, we do a lot of relief.
但是三月到现在，我们也做了很多救援的工作。
We still have around 10,000 masks in Bangladesh, but because of the virus, we have to slow down and stop in our office.
我们有一万个口罩要送去孟加拉，但是因为这个疫情的关系，现在还没办法到达。
And you see, people come to us. We use an opportunity that we can share the love of Christ.
很多人到我们这边来，让我们可以分享神的爱。
Another small country, Laos, and I think seldom people will visit this country.
还有一个小国叫辽国。
And it's a communist country and Buddhist country.
是一个共党跟那个佛教的国家。
And you can see the picture. There's people still have opium.
你看那个相片里面，这个人们还是在抽鸦片。
And if you see the church, you know Church of China, it looks like in 70, 80, or the house church in China is like that.
你看那个相片里面，好像是中国七八十年代的那个家教会。
And then you see another Burmese refugees.
下面是缅甸的难民。
And we have a couple of places to help the refugees there.
我们有一些地方是在帮助缅甸的难民。
And then that's refugees in Lebanon, Syrian refugees.
接下来有黎巴嫩、叙利亚的难民。
And you can see those children at the back, and it's the refugee camp where they live.And we serve and this people you see in the picture.
你看这些孩子们就是黎巴嫩难民营里面的孩子。
And we give them food package and all the things, supplies to help them to go through this difficult time.
我们给他们食物跟补给品在这个困难的时候。
And you see, this is all Muslim and they're so appreciate, you know, of our little help.
你看这些都是回教徒，他们非常感激我们给他们的这些
帮助。And this is what Pastor Chen ministry to us, you know, 100 times a folding of harvest.
这也是我们教会所支持的一个宣教事工，我们感谢神有100倍的这个收成。
And maybe $100 you cannot do much in America.
也许100块在美国你不能做什么。
But you can do a lot in Lebanon among the refugees.
但是在黎巴嫩难民营，你可以做很多的事情。
And we never, you know, really do much ministry in Lebanon, and because they are not very, very poor.
我们其实在黎巴嫩没有做很多事情，因为他们并不是真正非常非常穷。
But this time, and the Lebanese, they experience poverty severely.
但是这段时间，黎巴嫩他们经历很大的困难。
And I my colleague sent me a video clip.
我的同事送了一个短片给我。
And I saw a pregnant woman. I would thought she's 30 some years old.
我看到一个怀孕的妇女，大概三四十岁。
And they stood beside a garbage bin or like tall big.
他们就站在垃圾桶旁边。
And the husband going to search food.
先生在找食物。
And the whole footage was.You know, the whole process, and he finds some food.
在整个过程当中，他找到一点食物。
And but when I look at him, I felt he more hungry than her, his wife.
我看这个短片，我知道他比他的太太还要饿。
And they eat the food.
然后他们就分享这个食物，一点点食物。
And you know, they have no other choice.
因为他们没有选择。
And they cannot just die, they have a baby.
因为他们也不能够就都不管，因为他们还有一个小 baby.
And when we do relief, I remember my colleague told me, also a mother with like a 2 years old baby.
但我们的同工也分享说有一个这个妈妈有两岁的孩子。
This baby was cry and cry and cry for 3 days.
这个 baby 一直在哭，一直哭好几天了。
Because the family cannot provide meal for him.
因为这个家里没有办法给这个孩子牛奶喝。
And the baby want milk.
这个宝宝他就是想喝牛奶。
And so when we give the food package to her door,
当我们把这个食物送到她家门口的时候
，and she quickly opened it to see do you have milk for me?
她很快的把它打开了，说有牛奶吗
？And it was 1 week ago we received a donation.
在这之前一个礼拜我们收到很多的捐助。
We just give them rice and or bread and cooking oil, not milk.
我们就是有米啊油啊 就差不多这样子
Because for us, we want to bless more people
因为我们想要祝福更多的人
and, But because this special donation, we add some, a little bit more milk
但是这个特别的捐助我们也要求了有牛奶
And this Muslim lady was praying to God a night before we deliver this food package to her
这个妇人呢，在前一天晚上，她就跟神祷告说：“我们会送食物过来。”
If you God help me to touch them to give me milk for my baby.
她说：“神啊，你帮助他们能够送牛奶来给我的宝宝。”
So when she saw that, she screamed out, "God answer my prayer."
所以当她看到那个牛奶的时候，她就大叫说：“啊，神听了我的祷告。”
And we also give masks to the police.And also for the government official.
我们也送口罩给警察跟一些官员。
They don't have it, but they have to go out.
他们没有这些口罩，但是他们必须出去。
And so we reap many benefits, and they have a very good impact to them.
我们跟他们就建立了很好的关系。
And we, of course, we give to our, we have a small church there to our church member.
我们在叙利亚有一个教会，我们也给会友。
And then we ministry to the Armenian people.
在亚美尼亚人，我们也帮助他们。
And we also go to Syria.
在叙利亚，我们有一个。
And the Bible said, "Wake up, strengthen what is remain is about to die."
神叫我们要来让那些警醒，坚固那些剩下将要衰亡的。
It talking about church.
他在讲教会。
And what about the church in Syria?
那叙利亚的教会呢
？Are they good or bad?
他们怎么样了
？Are they maintain their faith?
他们是不是还有信心
？I can tell you many stories in Syria.
我可以告诉你们许多跟叙利亚有关的故事。
God's presence is there.
神的同在非常的彰显。
And we have mainly we have 2 place ministry in Syria.
我们在叙利亚有两个服事的点。
And very well known in the Bible, Damascus.
圣经上我们大家都知道的大马士革
We have a house of hope there We have over 120 children We every day we ministry to them
我们有一个希望之家在那里大概有120个孩子我们每天都服侍他们
And we, our school already open
我们的
center and the children come to our center
我们的这个希望之家呢孩子们会到我们这里来
And we already open We start our school now
我们就开始在那边有学校
And because the virus is not very, it's tough. But compare if they not we open the country and people have no food at all.
虽然疫情非常严重，但是如果我们不开门让他们来的话，他们连食物都没有。
And you see another picture, and our colleague said to me, he said the children go to the garbage and try to find food.
你们在这张图上会看到孩子们在垃圾堆里面找食物吃
or anything they can find they can sell and exchange food
或者是任何东西他们可以拿来换钱来买食物
and I remember one of the Muslim lady is a children's mother and talked to our colleague
有一个这个回教徒的孩子的妈妈来跟我们同事说
and she came with tears
她哭着来说
She said, you know, there's divorce you couldn't believe it's rapidly in the war room.
无法想象那种
离婚，
离婚在那个难民区是非常的大。
And then many left many widow with the children.
所以有很多寡妇和孤儿在那边。
So women take finance responsibility.
所以妇女要负起这个财务的责任。
And she said, "I have no my landlord chased me out. I have no place to live."
所以她就说，房东把我赶走了，我没地方住。
And all the food I have, I give the children as a priority.
所以我有的一点食物，我通通是给我的孩子。
I did everything I could.
我已经做我所能做的。
What can I do now?
我还能够做什么呢？
And she had no expectation that someone could help her.
她是已经放弃了，或我有任何人会来帮助她。
She just wanted to talk to someone.
她只是想跟人家说说话。
And she's a Muslim.
她是一个回教徒。
And for us, we won't say, you know, Jesus loves you, this kind of word.
对，我们不会说，哦，耶稣爱你这样子的话。
But our colleague really have find no word in this world.
但是我们好像在找不到怎么样子可以安慰她的话。
So my colleague and give her a heart.
所以我的同事就给她一个拥抱。
And I call this a cross religions heart.
这好像是跨宗教信仰的一个拥抱。
And then she said, "Jesus loves you."
然后就跟他讲说耶稣爱你。
And we have a little project called Project Cake.
我们还有一个计划叫做无花果计划。
And in northern Syria, war room still at war.
这是在叙利亚北边战区的难民。
Well, many people lost their life already. So what is remained is just like we birth after disaster.
很多人都丧失了他们生命，在这个地方呢，就好像是劫后重生。
And but what do you want? You know what? Why God remained them still alive?
但是为什么神还是存留他们的性命呢？
I believe God have His destiny.In their life,
我相信神在他们的身上也有他的命定。
And we support only 10 families there.
我们现在只有支持十个家庭。
And we more than give them food and finance.
我们基本上是给他们食物跟一些财务的资助。
And we every day our colleague send them a scripture.
每一天我们的同事都会送他一段经文。
And then they will talk to them about Jesus Christ.
他会跟他们分享耶稣基督。
I think this is what we want.
我想这就是神要我们做的。
It's not bread or food.
不只是食物或者是面包。
I think they need to be renewed.
他们必须要有一个
rebirth.
重生。
Just like he's sicker and he's supposed to die.
就好像西西家他本来是要死的。
But Isaiah came back to him and give him a cake of figs.
但是以赛亚来用无花果饼使他痊愈。
So this is the second life Hezekiah have.
所以这是西西家第二次生命的机会。
I think all of us.
我想我们每一个人也都是。
I'm not just talking about them. All of us.
我们每一个人都是。
We deserve the second chance.
我们都会有第二次的机会。
Why only I have this second chance, and they don't have that chance?
为什么我有这个第二个机会，他们没有呢？
So I believe God loves the world.
所以我相信神这么爱的这个世界。
How much God loves America, how much God loves Syria.
神怎么样子爱美国，神也爱叙利亚。
But also I believe how God can reveal His love.
我也相信神怎么样子能够彰显他的爱呢？
Is for you and for I.
是透过你跟我。
May God bless new life, bless us.And to prepare, we have a hundredfold of harvest.
愿上帝祝福新生命，愿上帝祝福你我，让我们都能够经历一百倍的收成。
Father, we thank you so much for this Sunday.
父神，我们为这个信息来献上感谢。
Father, this Sunday is ordained by you, even though we are separate in different places.
这个主日是你所命定的，虽然我们不能够在一起。
And we believe you ordained to bless us.
我们相信你是命定要来祝福我们。
We are not wasting our time.
我们并不浪费我们的时间。
God, you have a better dream for us, but a plan for us.
上帝，你有更美好的计划，更美的梦来给我们。
Help us to let go all the bitterness, all the bad things in our life.
让我们对过去的苦毒，过去的不好的事情说再见。
And we can say goodbye, and even we can embrace and kiss.
我们可以吻别说再见。
And we walk to a new chapter of our life.
我们可以走进我们生命中新的一章。
Which is a glorious chapter, the Lord you prepare for us.
是神为我们预备荣耀的一章。
Thank you, Jesus.
谢谢耶稣。
Bless new life, all the pastor, all the leader, leadership, deacons, and so on.
请你祝福新生命的牧者、领袖长、理事、弟兄姐妹们。
Maybe some of them, just like Prophet Samuel, was very discouraged for how much time he invests in Saul's life.
可能有些人感觉好像撒母耳，觉得、哦、我已经花了很多时间力气在扫罗身上。
And what a waste.
好像觉得很浪费。
But God have a new dream for us.
但是神对我们有新的一个梦想。
And we can move on for the will of the Lord, the destiny of our Christ.
我们要进入神给我们的命定，神给我们的梦想。
In Jesus' name I pray.
奉耶稣基督的名。
God bless new life.
上帝祝福新生命。
弟兄姐妹，我不知道你听完了这篇信息之后，神的灵在你的心里面做什么样的感动。
Brothers and sisters, after you've received、such a wonderful word from God, what is moving in your heart?
你是不是觉得你自己是住在天堂?
Do you feel like maybe you yourself, you're living in the kingdom?
所以我们可以看到美国这么好的地方。
And we here in America, such a wonderful place.
你很难想象在美国以外有很多的需要。
And sometimes it's very difficult to see that outside of America, there's so much that has need.
马太福音第二十五章三十五到三十六节，我来念给各位听。耶稣说：“因为我饿了，你们给我吃；渴了，你们给我喝；我做客旅，你们留我住；我赤身露体，你们给我穿；我病的，你们看顾我；我在监里，你们来看我。”
Matthew chapter 25, verse 35 and 36, Jesus said, "For I was hungry, and you gave me food; I was thirsty, and you gave me drink.I was a stranger, and you took me in. I was naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you visited me. I was in prison, and you came to me."
我想在这里耶稣提到最少六件事情，我们能够帮助那些周围需要的人。
Jesus brings up at least six different categories in which we are able to help those who are in need.
我想我们能够帮助在我们社区，在我们城市那些饥饿的人。
I believe that we can step out and help those that are in our community,
那些在医院里面生了病的人,
the ones that are in hospitals who are sick,
甚至可能是医院的护士跟医生,
perhaps the nurses and doctors,
有一些人是在监牢的里面,
some who are in prison and jail,
有一些人现在忽然间变成了 homeless,
some who are now homeless,
我们怎么能够关心在我们城市里面这些需要的人?
How do we go and care for the people in our society?
最近在我的心里面，神不断地提醒我们，不要只想到我们自己。
Lately, God has been really pressing upon my heart to not just focus on myself.
我非常鼓励新生命灵粮堂三个牧区的弟兄姐妹，让我们能够为主耶稣的缘故走出去。
And so I want to encourage all brothers and sisters from all three of our campuses to step out in compassion with Jesus.
耶稣说，我们若坐在这些人的身上，就等于坐在主耶稣的身上。
Jesus said, if we do unto these people who are in need, then we are actually doing unto Jesus.
所以为了回应这个给耶稣一分钟，这个 project.
And so for the sake of this project of reflecting and responding to God for just 1 minute,
我要鼓励从今天开始，每一个弟兄姐妹每一天最少花一分钟来祷告。
I want to encourage brothers and sisters, if you can, just 1 minute a day to spend with Jesus in prayer.
不单如此，我也要鼓励你祷告完以后，能够每一天省一块钱下来。能够来帮助这个 project.
And also, not only to pray, but if you can save $1 each time that you pray to help fundraise for this project.
我不要你一次给我30块钱。
I don't want you to at once give me $30.
我要你每一天 祷告完了以后才给这一块钱。
I would like to ask you that each time you pray to sow that $1 into your prayer.
弟兄姐妹，我们虽然能够给的一块钱是很少，但是那一分钟的祷告是带着能力的。
Although the things that we can offer, even the money that we can offer is very little, but that 1 minute of prayer can do much.
所以我要鼓励每个弟兄姐妹，一天每一天一分钟的祷告，然后为这个 project 能够奉献一块钱。
And so, again, I want to encourage everyone, every day, 1 minute a day to pray with Jesus, and then spend $1 to collect a fundraiser for this project.
但弟兄姐妹，你不要把给神的十分之一从里面扣掉哦。
But listen, don't take money out of your tithe, your monthly tithe.
给神的还是要归给神。
What belongs to God should still be given unto the Lord.
在我们底下有这个荧幕上面有几种奉献的方式。
On the image, you'll see there are three different ways we can offer and give to the Lord.
所以你可以选择任何一个方便的方式来奉献。
So you can choose whichever method is most efficient for you.
愿上帝祝福每个人的摆上。
May God bless every single person's offer.
也让我们的教会成为别人的祝福。
And let our church be a big blessing unto others.
好，我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
亲爱的天父，我们感谢你。
Dear Lord, we thank you.
我们所有一切需要的都是你供应给我们。
Everything that we have in life is provided by you.
主，我们为三个多月过去的疫情，你仍旧保守我们十分平安，我们献上感谢。
I pray for the last 3 months that, God, you have given us and you will continue to give us this peace for our journey.
主，我特别为在我们当中一些弟兄姐妹工作受影响的，或者他的事业受影响的来祷告。
And I want to very specifically pray for any brothers and sisters who have been affected in their work or in their finances.
主，我们相信你是爱我们的神，你必亲自供应我们的需要。
I believe, God, that you are a God that loves us so much, and you always want to provide all things that we need.
主，我也求你祝福这些在缺欠当中的弟兄姐妹，你给我们遇见一个好的机会。
And so I pray, Father God, that if there are those who are in need, Lord, give us an opportunity so that we can reach them.
主，我们谢谢你，也祝福每一个弟兄姐妹的摆上。
And so I thank you, Lord, that you would blessing everything that we sow.
奉耶稣基督的名祷告。
In Jesus Christ's holy name we pray.
Amen. Amen. 好，弟兄姐妹，我们有几件事情要在这里跟大家报告。
All right, brothers and sisters, there's a couple things we want to announce.
Santa Ana 的牧区，我们每个礼拜二晚上7:30都有在这里实体的祷告。
Santa Ana, we have every single week a Tuesday night prayer gathering that is on site here at the church.
我们会一直做到7月底。
We will continue to do this prayer gathering until the end of July.
那8月以后呢，我们会暂时停一段时间。
But in August, we will be stopping for a season.
当我们预备好的时候，我们可能会选择一个适当时间再重新开始。
And when we have found a time in which we want to restart this prayer gathering online, we will do that.
特别在这段时间，我们需要很多的人力来帮助我们。
Especially because right now we have need for a lot of volunteers and people to help.
所以我邀请大家，不管在线上或在实体里面，让我们一起用祷告来经历神。
And so whether you are online or you are here in our midst, that you would continue to pursue God with prayer.
不要忘了，7月22号，我们还有最后一次的这个好好说好话的研习会。
And don't forget, in July 22nd, it is our last workshop for the workshop of speaking well the good words that we have.
所以我希望这4次的 workshop 能够帮助到我们每一个人。
And so I hope that all of these 4 workshops have been helpful for your communication.
所以为了教会要重新开启，我们也需要很多的义工前来帮助。
And for the sake of reopening our church for the public and on-site service, we need lots of volunteers and people to help.
如果疫情如果有减缓下来，我们预计在8月的第一个礼拜，3个 campus 同时开始聚会。
If the pandemic seems to have slowed down a little bit, we will definitely be on track to start service in August.
所以我们继续为我们的国家来祷告。
So let us continue to pray for our country.
最后影音团队有一个需要就是希望有弟兄姐妹，不管你对摄影或者对音控或者对 PPT 投影片的制作有负担有兴趣的，可以跟教会来联络。
Now our media team has a lot of need as well, and especially we are looking to recruit some more volunteers to help out in these areas. So if you are somebody that enjoys audio tuning or video, videography, all sorts of different media forms, please help.
我们谢谢过去这三个多月来有一些背后的弟兄姐妹他们为我们所付出的努力。
And I really want to thank all of those brothers and sisters who are behind the camera, behind the scenes, doing many things to help us with our production.
最后不要忘记了，教会的 APP 已经出来了，所以如果你还没有sign in的，请你赶快跟你的小组长联络，把sign in跟教会有一个好的连接。
And lastly, is just a reminder that we have our church app. So if you haven't gotten on there, please grab that app and register and get connected with your cell leader.
愿上帝祝福每一个人。
God bless every single one of you.
在饥荒中撒种，新冠病毒席卷全球，人类正经历惊慌、无助和绝望。然而，神在苦难中搅动人心中的良善，将神的福音和慈爱传遍大地。由于疫情严峻，连富裕国家都缺乏口罩和消毒用品。因着弟兄姊妹的爱心和支持，桥梁事工筹得3万多个口罩和捐款。我们分发食物包、消毒用品和口罩到最需要的合唱。受惠者包括中东的难民、亚美尼亚人、树城居民、战争中流离失所的人、南亚贫民区的居民和内战连年的荔枝城难民。在黎凡特的橄榄城，我们帮助了100个因战争而流离失所的家庭。一位离婚的穆斯林妈妈泪流满面地说，她已经没有能力给孩子食物。他们到垃圾站去寻找残余的食物，却发现因为疫情，连垃圾也大大减少了。同工利亚听到后，忍不住拥抱这位绝望的妈妈，对他说，耶稣爱你。这个跨信仰的拥抱在黑暗中为沮丧的灵魂带来温暖和安慰。黎凡特的树城货币贬值3倍，通货膨胀严重，很多人已经没有能力购买食物，受苦的包括还在吃奶的婴孩。一位树城妈妈的2岁儿子需要牛奶，却没有钱购买，父母只能尽量安抚，但是孩子坚持要喝牛奶，因此哭了整整3天。当桥梁事工为他送上食物包时，他迫不及待地打开，看看里面有没有牛奶。当他发现有牛奶，激动地说，这是一个神迹。中亚的友谊城，大卫牧师接受桥梁事工的捐助。神在疫情当中做新事。从前只有穆斯林可以公开广播，但因着居家令，政府容许基督徒可以用大喇叭广播，在天台上聚会掰饼，因此福音被广传。感谢赞美主。在疫情尚未过去、经济未曾恢复的期间，桥梁事工会继续支援和发放食物包给孤儿寡妇、难民及贫困家庭。我们的目标是将肉体和心灵的食物一起送给他们。凡我所行的，都是为福音的缘故，为要与人同得这福音的好处。我们宣告，新冠病毒要成为我们的祝福，好土已经预备好。桥梁事工期望与你在这连绵荒年，在各饥荒之地 一起撒种，不要让祷告的声音停下来。我们要见到神的荣耀，并一同经历百倍丰收的喜年。阿门。